Hello, class 5. How are you? I hope you all are fine. So, children, take out your English language book. This is your English language book, you all know, isn't it? In the previous class, we were doing chapter 4 of your book, isn't it? And the name of the chapter 5. Okay. So, and the name of the chapter was pronouns. And we have done one exercise also. That was given on page number 20. And today, take out, open your book at page number 21. This is page number 21 of your book. And we will do this exercise today. Clear? Okay, children. So, take a pencil in your hand, children. All of you take a pencil in your hand. I will tell you how to do, and with me, you will do the exercise. Okay, what you have to do is rewrite the sentences using pronouns wherever required. So there are few sentences. Okay, so you have to rewrite the sentences using the pronouns wherever required. Wherever you feel you can make use of the pronouns, so you can make use of the pronoun. Okay, now see what you'll do. Now I will tell you what to be done here. Afterward, after the class, you will rewrite the full sentence, all the sentences here, the whole paragraph here. Understood? I'll help you to do this one. So with me, you will do that. Wherever we can use, make use of pronouns, you will do it here. And then after the class, you will rewrite the same sentences using a pronoun, okay, and with a very nice handwriting, okay. And just write properly, shouldn't be very light, okay, otherwise it is not legible, okay. Let us start. Number one, Lata is a very kind girl. I'll read the whole paragraph, okay. Lata is a very kind girl. Everybody loves Lata because Lata is very nice to people, animals, birds, and even insects. Lata has a friend called Nitesh. Nitesh is blind. Lata visits Nitesh daily and reads out nice stories to Nitesh. So what we have found here is we are continuously repeating the name again and again. So what is a pronoun? As you all know, pronoun is a word which is used in place of noun, isn't it? Because it sounds very odd if we go on repeating the same word again and again, isn't it? So to avoid this, we make use of pronoun. So what is pronoun? Pronoun is a word which is used in place of a noun. So let us see what can be done here. Okay, number one, Lata is a kind girl. First sentence, take a pencil, do with me. Lata is a kind girl. Everyone loves Lata. So as we have already mentioned the name Lata, here in place of Lata, we will write everybody loves her. Okay, here I am writing for you. Okay, so when you can rewrite the sentences here properly. Everybody loves her. Okay, now because Lata is very nice to people, so here you will write because she, in place of Lata you will write she, in place of Lata what you'll write, you'll write she. Clear? Now next sentence, she is very nice to people, animals, birds, and even insects. Again, in place of Lata, Lata has a friend called Nitesh. So you can write in place of Lata, she has a friend called Nitesh. Done? Then Nitesh is blind. So in place of Nitesh, as we have already discussed, already mentioned Nitesh, so we'll write he. Okay, Nitesh is name of a boy. So in place of Nitesh, we will write he. Okay, he is a boy, a blind, he is blind. Then Lata visit Nitesh daily. So here she, in place of Lata, visits him. In place of Nitesh, what you'll write? Him. She visits him daily. Okay. And reads out nice stories to Nitesh. Then in place of Nitesh, she will write him. Okay, then you'll give a full stop. So this is how you will rewrite this sentence, this paragraph. Okay, so how you'll write? See, Lata is a kind girl. Everyone loves her because she is very nice to people, animals, birds, and even insects. She has a friend called Nitesh. He is blind. She visits him daily and reads out nice stories to him. Clear? Is it clear? I think it is. Okay. Now we'll move to the next one, number 2. Let me read it out first. Rita is a clever girl. Rita goes to school. Rita has many friends. Rita's teacher tells Rita a story every day, every week. Rita has a little brother. Rita's brother doesn't go to school. Rita likes Rita's brother very much. Rita likes to play with Rita's brother. Here also we have seen repetition of the noun. Okay, so we will avoid the repetition. How? By using pronoun. Let us start. Rita is a clever girl, right? She, now again, Rita goes to school. You will write in place of Rita, she goes to school. Then again in the next sentence, Rita has many friends. So here you will write, she has many friends. Next sentence, Rita's teacher tells Rita a story every week. In place of Rita's teacher, what will write in place of Rita? Her teacher tells her a story every week. This way. Okay. Now, her teacher tells her a story every week. Rita has a little brother. Again, what will write? She. She has a little brother. Rita's brother. So, her brother. Now, in place of Rita's, her brother doesn't go to school. Now, Rita likes Rita's brother. Then, in place of Rita, you'll write she. She likes Rita's brother means her brother very much. Rita likes to play with Rita's brother. Here, what you'll write? She likes to play with her brother. So, this way you will complete this. Clear? Done? Can we move to the next one? Okay. See, number 3. Raju studies in class 1. Raju has a little pup as pet. Raju takes the pup for a walk in the evening. Raju's mother helps Raju to do Raju's homework. Raju's mother bakes a fruit cake for Raju every week. Raju plays game with Raju's father on Sunday. Raju's father has a holiday on Sunday. So in the same way, what we'll do, we will replace the nouns, okay, with a pronoun. Let's begin. I think you are ready with the pencil. Start. Raju studies in class 1. The next sentence, Raju has a little pup as a pet. So here he, in place of Raju, you'll write he. He has a little pup as pet. Again, next sentence, Raju takes the pup, here in place of Raju, he. He takes the pup for a walk in the evening. Raju's mother helps Raju. Here, his mother. In place of Raju, what you'll write? His mother. See, this way. His mother, then his mother helps him. His mother helps him to do his homework. Okay, now his mother helps him to do his homework. Raju's mother. So again, his mother bakes a fruit cake for Raju. Again, for him. His mother bakes a fruit cake for him every week. He plays games with his father. Okay, see, Raju, here he plays games with Raju's father, means his father. Again, here we will write his father on Sunday, right? Raju's father has a holiday on Sunday, means here again in place of Raju's father, what will write? His father has a holiday on Sunday. So, this way you will complete this also. This is number 3. Done. but you have to rewrite this here, okay, with a very nice handwriting. Then only send to me, okay. Now number four, the teacher was explaining the chapter to the students, but the students were not paying any attention to what the teacher was saying to the students. Okay, now here how can we change, replace the nouns with pronouns? Let us try. Are you ready? Yes. The teacher was explaining the chapter to the students. Here we are mentioning the name of the teacher and the student for the first time, so we'll not make any change. But the students were not paying attention. Here in place of the students, what we'll write? They refers to the students. Fine. They were not paying any attention to what the teacher was saying. So means to what the teacher. Here in place of teacher, you can write he or she, because a teacher can be a male or a female, isn't it? So common gender, as you all know. So the students means they were not paying attention to what he oblique she. This way you will write. Say. Clear? He or she was saying to students is written here. So you will write here them. T-H-E-M. Them. Clear? Have you got it? Say. Okay, so I hope all of you have written what I have explained to you. So rewrite these four paragraphs again in the space provided in the book and send it for correction. Okay, arrange them properly, then only you will send it. Okay, thank you.